So good day, dear colleagues. My name is Ekaterina Ivanova. I'm from the Institute of Limnology, Russian Academy of Sciences. And I would like to present our research results of climate impacts on runoff and nutrient load for the Gulf of Finland tributaries. This research has been done in the framework of the project SEVIRA. SEVIRA, the project SEVIRA, water meets people, learn, act, and influence. It is a project of a program Southeast Finland Russia cross-border cooperation. And its name, SEVIRA, it contains first letters of three rivers, Sestra River in Russia, Virajoki River in Finland, and Rakolanjoki, it is transboundary river. And the aim of this project was to take some steps forward to improve environmental situation in this area by combining some scientific and social activities. In this project, we did field research, monitoring works to analyze quality of water in the catchments of these rivers. And also we did modeling research to analyze possible changes. And our partners did some social actions, including surveys of local habitats, educational work with school pupils, cooperation with local activities, and others. So in the result of this project, we will develop recommendations and roadmap for stakeholders and decision makers. But in this presentation, I would like just to show our results of a modeling part of this project. And as I said, we did estimation of possible changes in runoff and nutrient load by the Gulf of Finland tributaries in case of a climate change. So to do it, we used two models which were developed in our institutes. It is a hydrological model of runoff and model of nutrient load. So hydrological model, it includes some hydrological parameters like precipitation, temperature, evaporation, snow cover and melting, soil moisture, and in the result we have total runoff, fast and flow, and can analyze water level in reservoir. And nutrient load model, it includes natural and diffuse anthropogenic load from agriculture and not agriculture areas, and also point load. And at the end, we have total nutrient removal in catchment and total nutrient load on water body. To verify our model data, we use calibration. So here you can see calibration graphs for three rivers. Red line is monitoring data, blue line is calibrated data, and black line is verification. So Nash Sutcliffe coefficient shows that our model data are quite satisfied and we can use it for further modeling. To estimate possible changes, we used scenarios of IPCL French model of a climate change. On the left graph, you can see four scenarios, but we analyzed just two of them. Green scenario RCP 2.6 when we have low emissions, and red scenario RCP 8.5 when we have the highest emissions. So according to these scenarios, we calculated changes in different meteorological parameters. For example, here you can see changes in precipitation for both scenarios. It increases a little bit in both cases. Then temperature, it doesn't change for the green scenario, and it increases significantly for the red scenario. We also calculated evaporation for both three rivers and runoff. So evaporation doesn't change for the green scenario and rises significantly for the red scenario. We have the same, more or less the same situation for three rivers, and the result, as a result, runoff, even decrease in case of green scenario and increase a little bit in the case of the red scenario. Here you can see our main results for the three catchments. So we can say that nutrient load in case of green scenario at CP 2.6, nutrient load will decrease a little bit for all three catchments. And in case of red scenario RCP 8.5, it will significantly increase. And for the catchments, the highest nutrient load we fixed for Rakolanjoki catchment, maybe it is connected with large sewage treatment plants in Lapinranta, and the minimum nutrient load was fixed on the Virajoki catchments due to high forest coverage. But these two scenarios are really extreme cases, and it is very likely that the real situation will be somewhere in the middle. And this is most likely that by the end of the 21st century, we hardly expected significant changes in the hydrological regime and nutrient load in the studied area caused by climatic changes. So there is the main conclusion. And we would like to say many thanks to our colleagues, Sirka Tatari and Jari Kosku from Suki Institute. Thank you very much.